Solving equations using equation solver. During this lesson, we will solve these four equations using equation solver on the graphing calculator. To access the equation solver feature on the calculator, press first the math key at the upper left of the keypad. From here, you can either scroll down to zero, which is solver, and press enter, or instead of scrolling down and pressing enter, you could have also pressed the zero key. If you have an equation like you have here at the top, we need to clear it out to have equation solver ready to use. To make it ready, we press the up arrow key, then press the clear key. Notice that having equation solver ready to use has the left side equal to zero and the cursor on the right side blinking, waiting for you to enter something. What this means is that in order to use equation solver to solve for this equation, we need to get one side of the equation equal to zero to do this. In order to get one side equal to zero, we are going to use the magic bridge method like we did in an earlier video. Let's put the bridge over the equal sign to use it. The easiest thing to do to get one side equal to zero is to get rid of the single term on the right, that 27. We could also make the left side equal zero, but that would take two terms crossing the bridge instead of just one. Let's move the 27 over the bridge to have the right side equal zero. What does the 27 turn into on the left side of the bridge? It changes to minus 27 or negative 27. Notice that we have nothing left on the right side, so we can just put in zero. Now our equation is calculator ready. We enter the left side of the equation. Now we use equation solver by pressing the alpha key, then the enter key that has the green solve above it. We see the cursor blinking over a number. In this case, we have the number 7. The problem with this is that it might be left over from the last time equation solver was used. So we press alpha again, then press the enter key to get the solve operation. And this time we get x equals 6. We check our answer by getting out of this view by pressing second key, then the key right next to it, quit. We store the value of 6 for x by pressing 6, then the STO or storage key on the left side of the keypad to store it, then we press the x key, then press enter. Now we return to the original equation. We enter the left side of that equation, then press enter. And we see that since it is 27, then x does equal 6. Check. Here's another problem. 10 minus 7n equals 32. Stop the video and see if you can solve this by yourself using equation solver, then restart the video to see if you got it right. First, make the equation calculator ready by getting 0 on one side of the equation. The easiest thing to move is the 32 to the left of the equal sign. The positive 32 becomes negative 32 on the left side and 0 remains on the right side. We get to equation solver by pressing math, then the zero key. To clear out the prior equation, we press the up key, then the clear key. Now we enter the left side of the equation. We can make the n by pressing alpha, then the log key on the left that has the n above it. Now we use the solver by pressing the alpha key, then the enter key that has the green solve above it. We do it again by pressing alpha, then enter to make sure the answer is not a leftover from another problem. And we get, as our answer, this negative irrational number. It looks like it's close to pi. Let's write it down to four significant figures to use it to check. Now let's re-enter the original equation and get to our home screen by pressing the second key, then quit. Let's store our answer to check it. So we put in negative 3.1429, storage, N, enter. Now let's enter the left side of the equation and press enter. Since 32 equals 32, we have verified that N equals negative 3.1429. Check. Let's do this one with an unknown on both sides of the equation. Let's set up the bridge over the equal sign. I want to move out the left side to get it calculator ready for the equation solver. Now, we could have chosen to move the right side to the left. It just matters we get 0 on one side. The positive 20 becomes minus 20 on the right side, and the minus 2x becomes positive 2x on the right side. We can put 0 on the left now. We get to the solver by pressing the math key, then the 0 key. We clear out by pressing alpha, then the up arrow. And finally, by pressing clear. Now, we enter the right side of the equation. Now we solve by pressing alpha, then the enter key. We press alpha, then enter again. And we see that negative 6 is the value for x. Now let's check by putting the original equation in place and pressing second, then quit. Store negative 6 for x by pressing negative 6, then the storage key, then x, then enter. Now enter the left side of the equation. 20 minus 2x. Then enter the right side of the equation, which is 44 plus 2x. We notice that both sides are equal, and that proves that x equals negative 6. Check. Let's look at the last one, 4y minus 12.5 equals 6 minus y. Again, please stop the video and see if you can solve it using the equation solver, then restart it to see if you got it right. I move the 6 and negative y to the left side and put 0 on the right side. So the 6 on the left side becomes negative 6, the negative y becomes positive y. Enter the left side into equation solver, then press alpha, then enter to solve. Then press alpha and enter again. We see that 3.7 is the value of y. We check by re-entering the original equation, then clear the screen, then enter 3.7 for y, then enter each side. Since both sides are 2.3, we know that 3.7 is the correct value for y. Check. We will try to have more lessons showing how to use equation solver. Thanks for viewing.